Hello, welcome to the Methuen Memorial Music Hall, home of the great organ. I'm Matthew Bellocchio, president of the Music Hall Board of Trustees. This is the 11th program in our 15-week summer series. We'd like to thank our sponsors, whose generous support is making this year's recital series possible. This program is sponsored in memory of Kenneth T. Morse. And we invite you, our viewers, to visit our website, mmmh.org, and click on the donate link to help support the music hall. Thank you. Tonight is our Summer Scholarship Fund Organ Recital, when we award our annual music scholarships. The Methuen Memorial Music Hall is a community music center, and we do lots of things besides organ recitals. The Summer Recital Series on the Great Organ is our flagship, but we have many other boats in the water. During the intermission, you'll hear about our music scholarships and meet this year's recipients. Stefan Donner from Vienna, Austria, was originally scheduled to play this recital. However, due to the continuing COVID situation, the U.S. border remains closed to European travelers. We are so grateful that Thomas Sheehan, organist at the National Cathedral in Washington, D.C., agreed to put together and play this recital on just a few weeks' notice. Tom is a graduate of the Curtis Institute of Music, where he received diplomas in organ and harpsichord, studying with Alan Morrison and Leon Schellhaus. He received both the Master of Music and Bachelor of Music degrees from Westminster Choir College in Princeton, New Jersey, as a student of Ken Cowan. He is currently a doctoral candidate in organ at Boston University as a student of Peter Sykes. Scholarships are an important investment in the future. They give bright and talented young people the means to help realize their potential. By coincidence, Tom was the recipient of a full tuition scholarship both at the Curtis Institute and at Boston University. His program tonight will include pieces by several contemporary American composers who may be unfamiliar to some of us. He will tell us about these composers and their pieces. We hope you enjoy this program. Now, please welcome Thomas Sheehan.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Can you hear me? Great. Thank you so much for coming. There it is. Thank you so much for coming this evening. Those first two pieces were the Overture to St. Paul by Felix Mendelssohn, a large oratorio in transcription by W.T. Best. That's the sort of music that this organ would have played originally when it was installed first in the Boston Music Hall back in the 19th century. And this program that I've assembled this evening is sort of between Boston and DC as the idea, since I used to live here in Boston and now I live in DC, all the pieces will be connected either to one of those two cities. So the first two pieces connected to Boston Music Hall, and then also Mark Fax, who wrote the second of the two pieces this evening, was the director of the School of Fine Arts at Howard University in Washington, D.C. for many years. And that's one of the historically black colleges in Washington. It's very, very well-known music program there. And a lot of the buildings are still named after him. It's a really great place. So those represent sort of an unsettled take on American neoclassicism in three different forms. The next piece is Rhapsody by Carson Cooman, a local Cambridge composer with whom I worked at Harvard University and who's joining us here tonight. We worked in the same office, so it's an honor to play this piece this evening and give it its Methuen premiere. The piece was originally intended for this organ, a version of this piece was originally intended to be performed here, but it ended up through various circumstances not being played here until tonight. So I'm really honored to bring it home to the organ for which it was intended.
Good evening. I'm Robert White, the chairperson of the Music Hall's Youth and Scholarship Committee. And tonight I have the very enjoyable task of giving some money away to a couple of very fine young musicians. But before I do that, I'll tell you a little bit about our scholarship program. Each year, the Music Hall awards scholarships to seniors from Methuen and neighboring areas in the Merrimack Valley who are planning to go on and major in a field of music in college. This program started back in 1974 when we were able to award one scholarship of $200. We have been able to grow the program, and now we're able to offer two scholarships of $1,000 each to these promising young musicians. To date, we have offered, including tonight's recipients, provided a total of $73,000 in scholarship aid to 94 young musicians, and we're very proud to have been able to offer this help to them. And I would say that tonight's proceeds from the concert go to support our scholarship program, but we very much depend also on contributions from the public. So if anyone feels inclined to make a donation to our scholarship fund, contributions in any amount will be most gratefully received, I assure you. And now let me tell you about this year's recipients. The first recipient, Marshall Juice, unfortunately, due to other obligations, could not be with us tonight. Marshall is from Somersworth, New Hampshire, where he was homeschooled through high school. He studied organ and piano performance and composition with his principal focus on organ performance. And for obvious reasons, the Music Hall is always glad to support a young organist. He'll embark on his music studies at Rice University's Shepherd School of Music in Houston, Texas, concentrating on organ performance. He aspires to perform in concert and worship venues, but also hopes to teach. He aspires to be a university or conservatory teacher. He has extensive performance experience. In fact, he's performed right here at the Music Hall in a concert with his sister on the harp, as well as in two of our young artist recitals that we've had. He's appeared on the popular NPR radio show From the Top. He's performed in summer concert series in York and Lewiston, Maine, and in numerous church venues and other settings. Marshall's awards and recognitions include a first place in the Boston chapter and second place in the Northeast region AGO-RCYO Quimby competition. He also, in different years, has a first and second place and audience choice award in the L. Cameron Johnson competition in Storrs, Connecticut. He's been awarded scholarships for advanced organ studies, and he also has been recognized on piano, placing second and third in the concerto competitions of the Portsmouth and Lakes Region Symphony Orchestras. In addition to performing and musicianship, Marshall is involved in his community, which is important to him, as a church organist and pianist, working with teen and adult church choirs, and doing volunteer work at senior living complexes. I always think those who know these students best can comment about them better than I can. And one of Marshall's piano teachers said of him, he's an exceptionally gifted musician with both excellent technique and inherent musicianship. An organ teacher who actually judged him in one of his competitions said, in that setting, he stood out as a player due to his demonstrable skill and a clear, exciting potential for growth. Yet the strongest impression he made came from how he comported himself. Marshall was unfailingly kind to everyone and was gracious in receiving both praise and constructive feedback. And we're very pleased to be able to award Marshall one of our two music scholarships this year. I'm glad to say our other recipient is able to join us, and I'd ask Nicole to join me up on the stage, please. And I'd like to introduce you all to Nicole Paquette. Nicole is from nearby Pelham, New Hampshire, and graduated from Pelham High School with, I have to say, superb academic accomplishments. I started as a math major, but still don't quite understand how one gets a GPA over 4, but Nicole's was 4.51. And if that's not impressive enough, she was a member not just of 1 or 2, but 6 different National Honor Societies, including, of course, the Tri-M Music National Honor Society. Nicole's principal instrument is the flute, but she also plays oboe, piano, and saxophone. And aside from being an academician and a great musician, she's also a dancer, a drum major, and a volleyball player. And she aspires to be a professional flutist and plans to attend the Hart School of Music at the University of Hartford in Connecticut. Nicole also has extensive performance experience in the high school band, to the jazz band, orchestra pit at a community repertory theater, the community music school flute ensemble, and other venues. She also has an interest in composition, with a number of sonatas for piano and arrangements for a variety of ensembles to her credit. Recognitions for Nicole include the University of New Hampshire Youth Advance Band, the New Hampshire Music Educators Association Chamber Ensemble Festival, and the NHMEA All-State Band Festival. Like Marshall, Nicole is also involved in her community. She volunteers to play and provide music theater at a local hospital and directs the middle school wind ensemble. And again, those who know her well have excellent things to say about Nicole. The band director noted, she quickly set herself apart as a leader with an incredible work ethic and maturity beyond her years. Nicole has proven herself to be a dedicated musician as well. I am sincerely amazed at the speed at which she progresses and the really mature and thoughtful musical choices she makes. And the music director and dean of fine arts at the school said, Nicole is what every teacher wants in a student: observant, competent, considerate, and gets the job done. Nicole's character is measured by her gigantic heart and vigorous work ethic. Among her best qualities, dedication, enthusiasm, charisma, reliability, extreme work ethic, and a world-class personality. And so it's with great, great pleasure that we award our other music scholarship this year to Nicole Paquette. Thank you. Thank you.
Wayne Dirksen, who wrote that final piece, that last piece, was the director of music and canon precentor at Washington National Cathedral, where I have the privilege of working now for many years. And this year, we're really excited to celebrate the centenary of his birth in 1921. So we've been, last February, we did a very large event at the cathedral, virtually, of course, celebrating Wayne's life and his works. And I'm excited to continue that today with the overture on Much Ado About Nothing, which was composed for a performance of the Shakespeare play at the National Cathedral by one of the student theater groups there. And Wayne wrote a bunch of incidental music for it, including that fantastic overture. The next piece is by Ohio-based composer Brenda Portman, and it makes reference to Washington, D.C. in its title, Monument, which is a reference to the Washington Monument. This piece was written for a composition competition in Washington, and it was inspired by seeing that amazing edifice. And musically, it makes use of two colonial-era songs that were found in a fiddle book published at that time. So it's a bit of history and a bit of Washington.
Thank you.
an American composer and professor of music at Boston College, just down the road, metaphorically. And that piece, Shepherd, Show Me How to Go, is an excerpt, a transcription of an excerpt from the last movement of his Fifth Symphony, which is for orchestra, but he made the organ version himself. The Shepherd, Show Me How to Go is a poem written by Mary Baker Eddy, the founder of Christian Science. And that's a famous hymn in that religion. This is not the melody that is most associated with that, but it's written so that the words could be sung to it. So it's a new melody for those familiar hymns from that tradition. Leo Sowerby, the composer of the next piece, was for many years the director of music at St. James, then St. James Church, now St. James Cathedral in Chicago. But then following his time in Chicago, he came to Washington, D.C. and ran the brand new College of Church Musicians, which was on the grounds of the National Cathedral and is about to reopen in a little while. The pandemic has changed our schedule a little bit, but we'll be reopening something called the College of Church Musicians very soon. And so Sowerby began that institution. This piece dates from his Chicago days, but it's well beloved in among our community at the National Cathedral nonetheless. It's in the form of a passacaglia, which is a dance, originally a Baroque dance. It's in a slow three, and there's a repeating ground bass line that anchors everything throughout this, and many variations happen on top of it that take us through all the colors of the organ. So please enjoy.